Officially, it is game six, but for the Sharks and their fans, it may as well be game seven. The Sharks face elimination down 3-2 as they host the St. Louis Blues in game six of this first-round Western Conference Series. Hi, everybody. I'm Dave Strader, and welcome to ABC's coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs. This series began with a goaltending question for the San Jose Sharks. Could rookie Evgeny Nabokov handle playoff pressure? Well, did he ever? A shutout win in game two, but he has not even dressed Jim Schoenfeld for the last two games. We're not sure why. And as good as the other rookie, Mika Kiprusoff, has been in goal the last two games, who gets the nod this afternoon?
Well, you're right. It's Nabokov today, and we don't know why. We've heard it was a shoulder. We've heard it was a back. We've heard it was a flu, but none of that matters. Nabokov is playing today, and for a very simple reason. Coach Daryl Sutter said, look, this is a goaltender that got us here. This is a goaltender that'll take us to the next level.
Game five went to overtime in St. Louis. The Blues won it, but the Blues caught a bit of a break.
Well, it was a break. It's a face-off drop, and the puck on the way to the ice will hit the shaft of the stick of Mike Ricci. Sometimes this will be blown dead. But Bryce Salvador, I'll tell you what, this is more than a kid being in the right place at the right time for his first playoff goal. That was a laser that would make Al McGinnis proud.
Speaking of being proud, nobody more proud than the two captains of these teams. They have battled for 12 playoff games over the last 2 years. They'll be going at it again this afternoon. Number 11 for the San Jose Sharks is Owen Nolan. He'll go head-to-head with number 44 again today, Chris Pronger of the Blues. Blues and Sharks, game six on ABC Sports, coming up next. Dan Marinelli and Dean Warren are the referees. Gord Brosnicker and Greg Dvorsky, the same two linesmen we had in game six, are here, or for game five, I should say, are here for game six. Roman Turek covers up. And it wasn't easy to get this building ready. And for more on that, let's go downstairs to Chris Simpson.
Well, guys, in a series as close as this one, 120 bounce can make the difference. Now, look for the ice conditions here to be the X factor in today's game. The reason? Well, none other than rock band U2. They had a concert here last night. The crew feverishly worked to get the ice ready, but it wasn't uncovered until 4 o'clock this morning. So it should be interesting to see what play the ice conditions have in this game.
All right, Chris, thanks very much. And not only pressure on the building crew, but a lot of pressure on our crew to get ready for this ABC telecast here this afternoon, and everybody doing a great job to make sure we could bring this to you. A face-off win by Don Foose and Brad Stewart's shot. That bounced off of Dallas Drake.
Take this time to mention how happy the fans were when Dave Strader had a guest appearance on stage last night with you two. Terrific job, Spades, as usual.
Oh, I wish I could have at least gotten to the building. Here is Pronger.
Oh, baby.
He took a big hit. Don Foose with a steal between the circles, sets it up. Turret the save. As the crowd reacts to the big hit.
Captain Chris Pronger, a little bit nonchalant to the defensive zone, going back for the puck, taking his time, circling the wagon here. Little fake. Owen Nolan wasn't buying the fake. A guided missile. There's Pronger. Here comes Nolan. No doubt about Owen Nolan's intention. Hit the big guy hard at every opportunity.
Well, you heard John Davidson right at the top talk about the difference in the penalty minutes for Chris Pronger in St. Louis versus here. And one of the ways to get Chris Pronger off his game, we just saw it from Owen Nolan. And the two of them have seen a lot of each other over the last 2 years. You go back to that series last year, Jim, 12 playoff games these two teams have played. Each has won six. But it's the San Jose Sharks who must win here this afternoon as Nabokov answers his first test as he kicks that Tkachuk shot over the glass and out of play.
Well, there's the hero of game two, Evgeny Nabokov. 1-0 shutout. And if the Sharks are going to win here in game six, I think he will most likely have to be the hero in this game, David.
Missed the last two games, of course, was pulled after the second period of game four, after his game three, rather, after his brilliant performance in game two when he earned the shutout win in St. Louis, 1-0. Gave up 5 goals in 2 periods in game three, sat out the third, and didn't even dress for game four when Mika Kiprusoff was the hero, or for game five when Kiprusoff played well, but in a losing effort. John Hill for the Blues sends it in deep. Marty Riesner, number 15, with the puck, the first lineup change for Joel Quenneville in this series. Reed Simpson, the tough left winger, is a scratch with Riesner in the lineup. Sundstrom sends it across. Here comes Ricci. Mike Ricci on the attack in the Blues zone. Had it poked off his stick. Recovered briefly by Sundstrom. He'll go in on Hamanoff and put a hit on him. Held in at the line. Chopped by Hanna. Doesn't get through. Ricci with a chop at it. And Turek covers up. And there are the San Jose Sharks trying to crash the net, and the Blues protecting their goaltender.
Joel Quenneville, the head coach of the St. Louis Blues, one win away from avenging last year's first-round playoff loss to these San Jose Sharks that he's facing today. And he would like to get the job done this afternoon. And you can see how important the first goal is. The team that scores the first goal, 9-1. The only loss was game four in St. Louis. So critical first goal always in the National Hockey League, especially in the playoffs. And as I mentioned, the Blues would like to get it done today. You go home for a game seven, anything can happen. If they can end it on Shark ice, they'll be more than happy to take that great plane ride home. And I'm telling you, there's nothing like the plane ride home after winning a series.
So the faceoff deep in the Blues zone. You saw that Chris Pronger is right back out there. Errol Sutter has the Patrick Marleau, Stefan Matteau, Teemu Selänne line that played well in the game five. Loss of steal by Selänne. Selänne taking it deep, goes behind the net. Matteau looking to shovel it out in front, went off a skate of Eastwood, the St. Louis center who had Patrick Marleau covered. And now Mellenby for the Blues sends it right into the glove of Nabokov, and he will hang on to it there.
Well, David, it's been a down, up, and then down again season for Teemu Selänne. Down late season, trade up. Well, he goes from a non-contender to a playoff contender. And he was just what they need, so that's another positive goal scoring. Shortly after he arrives, they discover he needs knee surgery. Bad news. Good news, he still has his shot. One of the best goal scorers in the game, game one, boom. That slash will eliminate his shot because that's a broken thumb on the right hand. That's a jam to left hand. So now you have a Teemu Selänne who doesn't have his electrifying speed, nor does he have that great shot. You can see him just easing into practice. Still trying to get the job done. Had two helpers in game five in a losing cause.
Shot for the point was blocked by Bill Lindsay, and Nabokov comes out. Ross McKeon of the San Francisco Chronicle quoting Teemu Selänne from earlier in the series, that Selänne admitting he has a broken thumb, which we suspected. We didn't know if it was broken. We knew that he just wasn't anywhere near the same player that he's capable of being. And if it was not a playoff series, Selänne would not be in the lineup. Stopped by McGinnis right at the St. Louis blue line. Dallas Drake rolls it in deep. Nabokov starts to come out, and he will play it around the boards. Selänne is there, avoided most of that Dallas Drake hit attempt. And Domfus with a second effort, able to clear it back out to center ice. Pronger lifting it right back in as the Blues look to go back on the attack. Remember, in the game three victory here by the Blues, they got off to the quick start with two goals in the first 4 minutes and 16 seconds. Marleau sends it back the other way. Here is Nolan. He sends it across. Good reach there by Pronger. Broke up that rush. Now Marco Sturm drops it back, and here is Scott Hannon for Mike Rathje. Hands it off for Marco Sturm, looking to go with speed. Sends it rink wide, looking for Nolan. Broken up by Jochen Hesch. Hesch to center ice, drives it in behind Nabokov. Nabokov stopping it there, and now Hannon picks it up, drives it around the boards. It is picked up by Sturm, and Marco Sturm will try to wrist it in deep, but it never got through. And back comes Hesch the other way. Right wing feed, Jamal Mayers with a shot, Nabokov the save. Rebound picked up, Mayers behind the net. He reverses on Stewart, puts it right out between the circles, and it rolls between the two St. Louis point men all the way back into the blue zone. Abanov sends it across. Marty Riesner just down the ice, could not play the puck. And Ricci now for the Sharks. Tries to just put it into some open ice, but the Blues get there first. Failed to clear, held in by Stewart. Sundstrom sets it up. Ricci back to Sundstrom. Tries to go back to the point. What a play by Tkachuk defensively. Got the stick along the ice. Tkachuk the other way. Drives the shot. Oh, and he hit the goal.
Oh, baby.
The save by Nabokov. Another chance for Tkachuk. He's covered out to the point. A shot. It's in the net, but the net was off the supports. The net was off the supports clearly, and the official, Dean Warren, right away saying no goal.
And show the hockey room just how loud the fans in the National Hockey League could be.
With Dean Warren coming over, because they have to announce in the arena officially what the reason is.
Well, we're used to seeing Keith Tkachuk get scoring chances in front of the net. He also has a tremendous wrist shot, as you're going to see right there. Nabokov gets a piece, and it just bounces off the post. And that would have had just enough to go in the net. had it been inside the goalpost. And there's a shot from Havanoff. Kachuk was crashing the net. You see San Jose Sharks flying all over the place. Most importantly for the Sharks, the net is off before the puck crosses the red line, so no goal. A faceoff in the Shark zone to the right of goaltender Evgeny Nabokov.
Now Kachuk can't believe it. He's had a fistful of great scoring chances. This shot right through and the save by Nabokov, and Lindsay now looking the other way but couldn't get it by Eastwood. Eastwood sends it back deeper into the Shark zone. It comes back to the line. Bryce Salvador, the game five hero, sends it deep. Ellaby wrapped up there. Good hit by Jeff Norton behind the net. And the outlet pass doesn't connect with Brian Marchman, who's back in the lineup after he was hurt here earlier in the series. Mellon with a drive, and Nabokov with the save. Let's go back to John Saunders and John Davidson for an update.
The Dodge different update. L.A. has been on a roll since late in the third period in game four, and this is Ziggy Palfy making it 1-0.
His second goal of the series, he got in behind Duchesne. It was an alley-oop type pass. Five straight goals now for Los Angeles in this series.
The Red Wings still reeling after the last one.
All right, guys, thanks very much. There you see how things stand now. Colorado waiting to see who they will play in the next round. And keep in mind, the highest seed will play the lowest remaining seed. It's not like the winner of Vancouver, Colorado, is going to play the winner of L.A. Detroit, as you see the bracket set up there. Though Colorado could still play L.A. They would play L.A. if the Kings pull the upset against Detroit, but they still could play Edmonton, or they could play the winner of this series. A lot of situations still up in the air, and we're this deep into round one. As the Sharks look to come out of their own zone, Sundstrom's pass across was intercepted by Turgeon. Sets it up now for Scott Young. Young had the first goal of game five. That shot never got through. Pronger holding it in. Scott Hannon will chase it down. And we have a whistle now. The official out at center ice has spotted something, and it's going to be a slashing penalty against San Jose. And it's going to be against Scott Thornton.
Well, this has been a concern for the Sharks, and Daryl Sutter playing with fire, the St. Louis Blue power play, although it has only scored four goals in this series, is very dangerous at any point in time with McGinnis and Pronger on the blue line. Kachuk setting up in front of the net, and of course the great playmaking ability of Pierre Turgeon and the quick release of Scott Young. So certainly ill-advised for the Sharks to be spending much time at all in the penalty box in today's game.
Blues have whistled six shots at Evgeny Nabokov. The Sharks only two shots against Roman Turek. Daryl Sutter said one of his number one concerns coming into the series was not allowing the St. Louis power play to be a factor, and he feels even though they've scored four on their power play, San Jose does have one shorthanded goal, and it hasn't been that big a factor except for the game three victory here, as Pronger could not get his shot all the way through. Now here is Scott Young with it, sends it out. McGinnis drives the shot of Nabokov, save, rebound. Turgeon set it up for Scott Young, and there was that bouncing puck on the ice. And McGinnis, his shot tipped by Kachuk, and that goes just wide of Nabokov. Good pressure by the Blues early in this power play. Turgeon with it. Sends it out. McGinnis, right point again. Tees it up, doesn't shoot this time. Now Turgeon. Kachuk battling in front against Rapchi. Turgeon's pass intercepted by Owen Nolan, and he'll dump it all the way down the ice.
Well, as we said before the game started, if the Sharks are to win today, Nabokov is going to have to be one of the game heroes. And right now, he has made some great saves on the St. Louis Blue in the early going of the first period.
Around the boards, McGinnis holds it in again for Pronger. Back for Al McGinnis, right point, winds it up, and that puck was on edge. And the shot was blocked. Here's Dopkus with it. He has the shorthanded goal for the Sharks in this series, but Mateau wisely decides to just dump it down the ice. We've played nearly 6 minutes here in the first period of game six, 45 seconds remaining in the Thornton penalty. Okenhesh had it tipped away, and it's cleared by Ricci all the way down the ice. John Hill for the Blues, out from behind his own net. Canceled off for Havanoff. Havanoff to center ice, getting it in deep, and Nabokov settles it down. He goes high on the glass with it. Nicholas Sundstrom doing a good job getting some help, but the Blues able to hold in the clearing pass. Pavel Lemitra goes to the corner with it. Marty Reisner took a hit, so Reisner in the lineup getting some power play time, and the Sharks here able to clear. It was Rapchi that got it out of there. 5 seconds left in the San Jose penalty. Hamanoff, he's outside, drives the shot that was deflected by Hannon. John Hill fans on the shot, held in at the line as Jamal Mayers lobs it in deep. Krafchi and Mayers. Now Reasoner, number 15 for the Blues, is over there. He throws it back into the corner. Just to the left of Nabokov, Sharks come up with it. Hannon got it to Marco Sturm, and he clears it down the ice.
Well, with Marty Reasoner in the lineup for Reed Simpson, Joel Quenneville must be thinking that toughness will not be a factor in today's game. He doesn't see this becoming a nasty game because it's too costly to take bad penalties.
Here's Solani trying to work against Bryce Salvador. Mateau centering pass. Patrick Marleau sends it back to the point. Markman with a screenshot tip. Turret to save with the rebound. Goes just wide. And Scott Young starts it ahead for Dallas Drake. Now for Turgeon. That's broken up and cleared to center ice. Good job by Marleau to stay after that puck. Scott Young is going to start back the other way. Here's Marleau. He's got good speed. Gains the St. Louis Blues zone. Puck is knocked away by Corey Stillman and cleared to center ice. Longer clears it to the neutral zone, and it comes back in offside.
Well, a couple of hits in the first period going the way of the San Jose Sharks. The first hit, that big one by Owen Nolan, and the second hit is the puck hitting the goalpost behind Nabokov.
To a game seven. The Sharks historically have faced elimination 9 times, a record 4-5. 3 of those games have gone into overtime, and they have lost 2 of those. No surprise, Jim Schoenfeld, to anybody in the hockey world, that this has been as tightly contested series as it's been, that we've gone to a game 6 and quite possibly could go to a game 7. I think most people expected a long series.
Yeah, we knew it would be long, and we knew it would be extremely physical, and we have not been disappointed for 1 minute of the 5+ periods, or 5+ this period in the games that we've covered. It's just been magnificent hockey. Just about as intense as you could get without having every player wind up in the hospital.
Here is Lindsay with a drive from a tough angle, and the save made by Turek.
The Sharks doing a good job in the forecheck. They have the Blue defenders off balance. They're creating some turnovers. And right there, Bill Lindsay almost capitalizing that turnover with a good shot on Roman Turek. And there's a forecheck right there by Todd Harvey. Rolling puck, a good blast. Turek gets down, makes sure the 5-hole is closed. And freezes the puck for the faceoff.
You mentioned all those guys going to the hospital after a first-round loss. Does a coach ever get hospitalized after going through the grind of a playoff war like you had with St. Louis in 99?
Just ulcers, that's all we have. No injuries, just ulcers.
Daryl Sutter calm on the outside. And seemed rather confident talking at the Sharks practice facility yesterday about his team's chances. Now Pronger, checked there by Thornton. Eastwood coming back to help out, and Tkachuk now for the Blues. Sends it back the other way, intercepted by Brad Stewart. Stewart chopped at there by Eastwood. Got it in deep. And Pronger plays it off the glass. Stepping up was Thornton, but he couldn't control. And Reasoner starts it back with some speed. Bouncing puck on Tkachuk. Now along the boards, Reasoner takes the hit. Thornton for the Sharks plays it along the boards. And Sundstrom now goes to Brad Stewart. Stewart with Ricci cutting for the net. Pass for Ricci, poked away. Very calmly by the 35-year-old veteran Alexei Gusarov. Marco Sturm for the Sharks, though, holding it in. Here comes Domfuss. Just off the bench, sends it around the boards. Marco Sturm has it in the corner. Sends it back now for Owen Nolan. Nolan out to the line. Here's Rafty, steps up, drives the shot. Deflected just wide by Turek. And now here is Sturm in the corner, behind the net again. Rapper on attempt, stopped by Turek. Another pop at it. Turek had it for a moment, then lost it. Owen Nolan going in to put a pretty good hit on Keith Tkachuk. And we're going to get an icing call here as Tkachuk and Nolan going after each other. And they probably figure, if I'm going to go, I'm going to take the other guy with me. And it looks like they are both going to go. Well, two guys that get along a lot better. Standing by in our studio, John Saunders and John Davidson.
JD just dropped the gloves on me moments ago. A Dodge Different update. Pittsburgh and Washington. Ferentz gets his first ever playoff goal.
He's a defenseman on the ice with Mario Lemieux's line. He got the first one. Now watch this assist he'll get because he put the shot on goal. There's Mario. Mario's line plus two early.
For Mario, the 73rd of his career in a playoffs. 2-0.
All right, guys, thanks very much. Owen Nolan in the box, so is Keith Tkachuk.
Two of the best power forwards in the National Hockey League. We're used to seeing these guys score goals, but they're both very physical players. Nolan with a hit, Tkachuk the little tap. And here's what happens when you get two highly competitive guys face-to-face in the Stanley Cup playoffs. Push comes to shove, and someone's trying to get that last right cross in.
There you see the two players in the boxes. We're just shy of the halfway mark of this first period. Four skaters aside. And a scoreless first period. We're at the Compact Center here in San Jose, home of the Sharks, for game six of this Western Conference quarterfinal. Dave Strader along with Jim Schoenfeld. Christine Simpson is with us as well. Blues leading this series, looking to end it here. The Sharks battling to force a game seven, which would be played Monday night in St. Louis. This Sundstrom pass deflects high in the air and off the glass on the far boards, and the Blues have it now as both teams looking to make some changes. Marleau back to get it. Patrick Marleau, two goals in the series. Hands it off for Mateau. Stephane Mateau sends it deep. It'll be picked up by Salvador. Bryce Salvador. Around the boards for McGinnis. McGinnis didn't get much on it, but Scott Young was there. To corral it for Dimitrov. Pavel Dimitrov drop back. McGinnis a drive and a save by Nabokov. So Nabokov has answered the call. How about the rest of the guys in white, the San Jose Sharks? They must win this afternoon.
Velocity on it. He has such great control. He rifles this one right into the crest of Nabokov. And McGinnis is almost like these pitchers. They come out and they throw 100-mile-an-hour fastballs, but they're always in the strike zone. He may be a little more effective if he rifled the odd shot up around the goaltender's ears, get him thinking high, and then blast one right along the ice as the goaltender's pulling his head away from the shot that almost took it off by McGinnis.
Here is Ricci now for Solani. Still four skaters aside. Solani has shot deflected wide of Turek. That's about as much velocity as we've seen Solani get on a shot.
I believe that is the first slap shot we have seen Timo Solani attempt in the series.
Nabokov easily steers aside the young shot. Salvador runs right over the top of Ricci, and then Rathje with a hit on Turgeon. Half a minute still remaining in the coincidental minors to Tkachuk of the Blues and Nolan of the San Jose Sharks. And this is going to be an icing call as Brian Markman goes back to touch up, and what a job that Daryl Sutter and the coaching staff, and I guess the training staff, has done too for that matter. Brian Markman has been out of this series, missed game five. They've missed Marcus Ragnarsson in game four, and of course there's been no Gary Suter since early in game one of this series, and Markman is not 100%.
This is the hit, Mellenby on Suter. As you mentioned, we haven't seen Gary back. The shoulder pops out right there. Marcus Ragnarsson, they pop it back in, he finishes the game. The skates collide, Tkachuk and Marchment. Marchment is back. Ragnarsson is back. Suter, of course, is not. And Scott Hannon, 22-year-old youngster, has emerged as a bona fide star in the making in the National Hockey League. He has done a great job on the blue line, as has youngster Brad Stewart and the entire defensive corps. So kudos to the coaching staff and, as you mentioned, the training staff of the San Jose Sharks.
Little delay on this faceoff now, and we know how important faceoffs can be. We saw it on the game-winning goal in game five. Marchman holding this puck in, winds up for a shot. Turek. Well, he showed good balance there and good focus, steered it to the corner. Now Damfus battling against Pronger. Eastwood for the Blues there as well. Drops it back in deep for Gusarov. Gusarov moves it along for Jochen Hesch as Nolan and Tkachuk come out of their respective penalty boxes. Hesch plays it off the glass deep into the San Jose zone. This will be an icing call on the touch-up by Marchman. It is the symbol of excellence in hockey, and next Saturday, the quest for the Cup continues right here on ABC. Who will win it this year? The Stanley Cup Conference Semifinals next Saturday, live at 3 Eastern, noon Pacific. Check your local listing for the game in your area. The NHL on ABC, home of the Stanley Cup. A sold-out Compact Center here in San Jose. They say home ice advantage only matters when it's a game seven. Well, for the San Jose Sharks, for all intents and purposes, Jim Schoenfeld, this is their game seven. They must win here this afternoon.
And no one knows it better than does Daryl Sutter. Great season. Things were going along so well for the Sharks, and then injuries, especially the injury to Vinny Dompoos, the suspension to Owen Nolan, and things came crashing to a halt. They did make it in the playoffs, but even that, at one point in the year, they had a 17-point playoff cushion, and it almost entirely evaporated because of the injury to Dompoos, the suspension to Nolan, and then a team that's kind of wondering, are we really as good as people think we are, or was our early season, first probably five months, a fluke? Well, it's no fluke. They're a good hockey team, but the injury bug has continued. We mentioned the defensemen, and early in the game, we mentioned the injury to Teemu Selänne, and that is a real big loss because the Sharks are not a team that scores a lot of goals, so they really need a guy like Selänne healthy.
Al MacInnis stepped up in the neutral zone and forced Jeff Norton to lose his stick. See what Darren Manuelli has to say.
Number two for St. Louis receives 2 minutes for slashing.
So the Sharks get a power play. Let's go back once again to the studio. John Saunders, John Davidson.
Buffalo trying to close out the Philadelphia Flyers for the second straight game. Andrejczyk from the boards, Gratton with the tip.
First goal of the game here, Gratton's fourth of the series. Every one of his goals have given his team the lead. He never scored one goal, period, in the playoffs last season.
Sabres at home, a step closer to moving on.
All right, guys, thanks very much. What a time for Chris Gratton to emerge as the kind of scorer everybody expected when he was drafted.
And what a time for the San Jose Shark power play to emerge. They are one great big donut so far in this series, and could not be better time for them to score a goal. And great credit must be given to the penalty killers of the St. Louis Blues and goaltender Roman Turk.
You see, they've been outscored actually on the power play with no power play goals, and the Blues having the shorthanded goal by Dallas Drake in game three that turned out to be the game winner. This is where the Sharks have had most of their problems, is when they have to come out of their own zone and get something established. And right there, Dompoos, good job physically to help get control of the puck. They go out to the point for Ragnarsson. It's knocked away, picked up by Jochen Hesch. Pronger jumping into the play. Ricci coming back to make it a two-on-two. Nabokov, watch that shot just whistle high and wide. And Havanoff tried to get it deep again, but it's intercepted by Ricci. Center ice now for Owen Nolan. He tried to get back and tag up, but it is a two line pass. That gives us an opportunity to go to our Bud Light Stanley Cup summary. Six of the series of the eight first round series will play at least a game six. 13 overtime games in the first round. The NHL first round record is 14, set back in 93. And Pierre Turgeon, is he ready for the playoffs? I guess so. Two goals, seven assists, leading the entire NHL.
Part of the problem for the San Jose Sharks, maintaining offensive zone possession on the power play. Right there, they lose the one-on-one battle, and away goes Jochen Hecht, with Pronger trying to make it a two-on-one. And I'll tell you what, Hest was going top shelf the whole way there. Nabokov was going to go down on the butterfly, tried to go short side over his shoulder, and that just missed going over the crossbar by about maybe 8 inches.
Here is Mateau, who had one of the two Shark goals in game number five. It goes out to the line, and Brad Stewart could not hold it in. Ragnarsson. Now it comes on the near side for Selänne. Selänne pinned to the board by Salvador. Now Young under some pressure from Mateau. Patrick Marleau ran about as hard as you can run into the net without knocking it off the support. And back comes Dallas Drake from the blue line. Fires it well wide of Nabokov. But we're down to 40 seconds in this Al MacInnis penalty, and the San Jose Sharks have not even had a hint of a threat with the man advantage. Now Turek high up on the glass with it. It's taken here by Jochen Hesch and cleared all the way down the ice. Now it comes to Marco Sturm. Sturm with some speed. Drops it back now for Hannon. Hannon rolls it back in deep. Havanoff gets there, knocks it away. Hannon moves it from the point. Checked there by Jochen Hesch, now down to Sturm out to the line. Hannon with a drive. Glove saved by Turek. He saw it all the way. 5 seconds left on the MacInnis penalty.
Bad news for the Sharks. Roman Turek looks very solid in goal, and you can see the difference that a year can make. Last year's playoffs, 870 save percentage. Of course, the Blues lost. And this year, the 923, and he comes up with a pretty good glove save. There's Hannon with the shot. Turek sees it all the way. Good NHL goaltenders will stop that shot. That's why you need traffic in front of them. Must distract the goaltender. Opportunity for a tip, opportunity to rebound. You allow them to see it all the way. They're going to do what Turk did. Not only make the save, but control the rebound.
Faceoff controlled here by Ricci. Rapti rolls it across. Rapti gets it back. His shot doesn't get through. Sexton with a chance at sliding across. Here's Turek. Not sure what it got through to him, but the goaltender for the Blues was in position. Now the puck squirts free, and McGinnis out of the penalty box hands it off for Dallas Drake. And Drake, center ice, has it knocked away. Now Dimitra for the Blues. Fans on a shot. Rapti hands it off, and Thornton's pass is taken now by Hannon. He turns it over back the other way. Pavel Dimitra hands it off. Turgeon, delayed call coming against San Jose. Turgeon behind the net. Sends it out to McGinnis. McGinnis winds up, gets the shot away. That is blocked by Sundstrom, and that stung him. And now we have a whistle for the penalty. And I think holding the stick is going to be the call. The St. Louis Blues going on the power play.
West Airlines goal cam, Roman Turk's going to make that pad save on Nicholas Sundstrom. Keith Tkachuk turning over Scott Hannon, and Hannon in turn grabbing the stick of Tkachuk. There's going to be a penalty. Tkachuk is knocked to the ice, and you see the skate come in there. And Tkachuk was at the bench getting his hand looked at, so hopefully there is no major cut there for Tkachuk and the Blues.
Back to the line, McGinnis, and that puck rolled away from Pronger, and it is offside. Let's go back to John Saunders and John Davidson once more.
Dave Andrechuk was silent through the first four games of this series. Now he's got it going here. Sets up Doug Gilmour.
Power play goal on the rush. Audet, Gilmour, Andrechuk. Everybody goes to the net. The puck went off of Richardson's skate. And Gilmour had the wide open side. A big 2-0 goal.
About 4.5 left in the first period. 2-0 Buffalo.
All right, guys, thanks very much. Game 6, Brett Hall and the Stars trying to close out the Edmonton Oilers, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific tonight on ESPN's National Hockey Night coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs on our family of networks. Dave Strader, Jim Schoenfeld, Chris Simpson, glad you're with us here from San Jose, where the Sharks face elimination and face a potentially very dangerous St. Louis Blues power play. Turgeon for Scott Young had it tipped away, and it bounces away for Chris Pronger as well. Sharks penalty killing, one of the best in the league during the course of the season. Blues taking some time to get their fresh power play unit out there. McGinnis and Pronger will remain, but now it is Tkachuk, Dimitra, and Corey Stillman up front. Pronger from center ice drives it in wide of Nabokov. Tomley steers it aside for Jeff Norton, high up on the glass with it, and it sails out of play.
Captain Chris Pronger, no penalty minutes, games 1 and 2, and he exploded here in games 3 and 4. The San Jose Sharks taking a piece of Pronger at every opportunity. And make no mistake about it, as Chris Pronger goes, so go the St. Louis Blues. When he was injured this year and out of the lineup, it was a void that just could not be filled by any other member or group of members of the team, and no one knows it better than that man right there, how valuable both Pronger and McGinnis are to the St. Louis Blues hockey team.
Chris Pronger, first team All-NHL last season. The Norris Trophy is the best defenseman in the league, and the Hart Trophy is the league MVP. As Pronger sends it across now, Tkachuk. Battle there with Jeff Norton. Pavel Dimitra. Look at the hustle by Ricci. Goes down to the ice, but couldn't clear the zone. McGinnis winds up, gets the angle. The shot doesn't get through. Loose puck in front of Nabokov. Sharks come up with a fail to clear. Backhand dump and save made to Nabokov. And Ricci, look out. He did just catch the low glass down below us and get that puck all the way down the ice.
Magnificent save by Evgeny Nabokov. What quick legs he has in this afternoon's hockey game.
Here is Stillman dropping it back. Dimitra took a little slash there at Marco Sturm, and Owen Nolan, he knew that Pronger was coming after him, but he was able to clear it out. So the Blues power play a lot more dangerous than the Sharks power play, but still not able to convert. 0 for 2 now. As Jamal Mayer sends it in deep. Here comes Nabokov out to play it. Solani with it. His outlet pass doesn't get through. Now it is chopped out of there by Stewart. Amanoff puts it around the board. Oh, big collision, Jamal Mayer and Marcus Ragnarsson. Now Nabokov out to handle the puck. Ragnarsson, nice little short outlet pass down. Boost down right wing side for Solani. Solani out there with that boost. And Thornton as this puck deflects over the glass and out of play with 2:41 remaining here in the first.
Well, the way the two goaltenders are playing today, David, you don't want to make a mistake that's going to result in a goal against, because it's going to be very difficult to get it back. They're getting a Bach off a terrific save. A backhand attempt by Corey Stillman. And you'll see the giveaway right there as Norton tries to clear it up the middle. And a veteran like Jeff Norton knows if you're going to clear it when you're in trouble, go to the boards, Jeff. And you're young defenseman, you want to clear it from the front of your goaltender. You know where you're going to put the puck. So if you just put it to the boards, you've got a head start on everybody else. You can get there, win the race, and then go off the glass and clear the zone. Anything up the middle can be intercepted, and in one swipe, it can be a shot on goal, which can result in a goal and face off at center ice. So keep the puck to the side, keep the puck to the boards.
Stay with us for the Dodge Different Intermission Report. John Sonner, John Davidson taking you around the National Hockey League first round. And Darren McCarty of the Detroit Red Wings tells his story. All that coming up on the Dodge Different Intermission Report. Got a glimpse of the tremendous atmosphere here in this building they call the Shark Tank. Comes the closest, I think, to any of the old-time buildings like Chicago Stadium, the Boston Garden. As that puck deflected over the glass and out of play.
The shame is that we cannot duplicate those old buildings when we build the new ones. We need all these sky boxes, and of course with the fire code, the pitch of seats cannot be as steep.
Right.
So you don't have that intimate feeling of the fans hanging over you. And there are some terrific new buildings that have been erected around the National Hockey League. Everything about them is wonderful, except the atmosphere cannot match that of the old ones.
This comes the closest, I think, of any of the buildings. And face-off win by the Blues. McGinnis steps up. He drives the shot. Nabokov the save. Boy, you can hear that thump off the pads. Solani now double-teamed by a couple of Blues, but battled through that. And it's back into the St. Louis end. Salvador takes the hit, but clears the zone. Rapchi back at center ice to get it. His backhand pass intercepted by McGinnis. McGinnis winds up, drives the shot. That was blocked by Hannon, and that stung him. Well, it's great. Checked by Rapchi around the boards. Marlowe trying to get to it, but it rolls out of his reach. Pronger for the Blues. Sends it rink wide for his partner, Gusarov. Dallas Drake backhands it into the San Jose zone. As we're down to a minute 45 left here in the first period of game 6. Sharks win. We have a game 7 Monday night. Blues win. They go home to rest for a few days before round 2. Todd Harvey sends it back in deep. Pronger is there. Pronger able to get some help in clearing the zone. Tony Granato was in on the forecheck for San Jose. Stillman sends it on the near side. Brad Stewart hustles over. He gets it. Stewart long pass center ice. Deflected off the stick of Bill Lindsay. And the Blues recover off the glass. And it skips out to center ice. Todd Harvey has it now. Puts it in deep. Blues get back to get it. Here's Marty Reisner. Reisner to center ice. Sends it deep into the San Jose zone. That is Marcus Ragnarsson, number 10 for the Sharks. Hands it off for Dombus, and Dombus had it knocked away, gets it back. Now it comes to Owen Nolan. Little backhand flip for Dombus, and a good job by McGinnis to tie him up. Roman Turek shoots the puck very well, and he displays that talent. Here is Marco Stern going wide, gets a shot away, that's blocked by Pronger over the glass and out of play.
Well, Blue defenseman Al McGinnis making his presence felt in today's game defensively and certainly offensively. Already has 4 shots on goal in this first period. And he's had 3 blocked. This is a shot that gets through. Nabokov well on top of the crease. Has an easy time stopping that. And then Scott Hannon, not quite as easy a time because he doesn't have those big pads. That hit him just on the laces. Tough kid, Scott Hannon, he's all right. Went to the bench, and tough shooter, Al McGinnis.
Block shots, the Sharks have gotten in the way of 5, and the Blues have stopped 2 of the San Jose shots. not surprising the Sharks would have more simply because the Blues are an offensive team that tries to get more pucks to the net. And with guys like McGinnis and Pronger, especially back there firing away, you're going to have more opportunities for blocks. Owen Nolan couldn't corral that pass. Pronger was ready for down. Who's coming at him? Nolan got a pretty high hit there on Jochen Hecht. And now the puck was played with a high stick by the Blues. And so 4.3 seconds on the clock. It's been a very tight and at times kind of tentative first period for Daryl Sutter and the Sharks. They don't mind this kind of game, though. This is what they like to play. I guess the only negative has been the two penalties and the Blues with some scoring chances on their power play.
Yeah, the Sharks are at their best in a tight checking game, a slow-paced game, not much speed generated through the neutral zone. Skill for skill, the Blues have more highly skilled forwards, better scoring touch, so if the game does open up, that certainly favors the team in the dark sweaters.
Just 4.3 seconds on the clock as Jochen Hecht was giving Brian Marchman a tough time. Owen Nolan's the guy that's back on the blue line that Ricci will try to get this puck to if he can. Nolan steps up, gets a shot away, save made by Turek. 4.3 seconds is not a lot of time. But Roman Turek had to come up with the big save.
Right off the snap, off the tackle, Owen Nolan bolts his way through there. A good faceoff setup, a great shot, and a real good save. Bad coverage by the Blues there. Ivanov very late in his coverage. Turek yet another good save.
Keeps the game scoreless. The Dodge Intermission Report with John Saunders and John Davidson is next after these messages and a word from our ABC stations. ABC crew here on a Saturday afternoon in San Jose. Blues lead the series 3-2. If they win, it's over. If the Sharks win, game 7 on Monday night. Back in St. Louis. Here's Marco Sturm. Drops it back for Domfus. Domfus trying to go back to Sturm, but it was intercepted by Ponger. He makes the outlet down to Dallas Drake, who clears it out to center ice. Recovered by Nolan. Nolan knocked to the ice, but the puck is in deep. Lucerov. Double team there by Sturm and Domfus. Domfus knocks the puck clear, but it's recovered by Pierre Turgeon. Back comes Turgeon the other way. Hands it off for Dallas Drake. Drake half to the front of the net. Scott Young got a stick on it, but couldn't get it on goal. Sturm coming back the other way with Nolan. Trying to catch the Blues on a change. Sturm with a drive. He missed it in. Ricci with it just off the bench. Tied up there by Pierre Turgeon. Now Ricci upended. And Pavel Demitra. The Blues have been waiting for number 38 to awaken offensively. He is out there on a line with Marty Riesner and Keith Tkachuk. Now the puck held in again. It winds up, drives the puck well wide of Nabokov. Right Salvador. That puck flutters in. Gets it back from Tkachuk. This wrist shot doesn't get through. Tkachuk picks it up. Save Nabokov. Rebound Tkachuk. That doesn't get through the crowd. And Nabokov wielding his stick against Marty Riesner. Demitra again. Intercepted by Hannon. Hannon plays it up the board, but not out. Ricci able to clear the zone, and here comes Sundstrom with it. He's got Scott Thornton jumping into the play. Thornton shot. Deflected in front, and Turek has it covered.
Both goaltenders into the second period in a hurry. In the first period, the Blues had more and better scoring chances. And you see the block out right there off the Tkachuk. Gets a little help from the goalpost. This was in, but the net was off, so no goal. And Corey Stone with a good backhander and the great right pace save by Evgeny Nabokov. And moments ago, it was Nabokov once again. And a snapshot by Keith Tkachuk. And then at the other end, Roman Turek with traffic in front as Sundstrom just gets his stick on that and tips it. And Turek wisely hangs on to the faceoff.
And Marchman could not hold that in. Stephane Matteau sends it in deep. Solani is there. Now behind the net. Matteau trying to set something up. Cup angle shot, and Turek made the save. And a couple of slashes exchanged as Turek had that puck covered up.
Quick snapshot, Roman Turek very alertly gets the legs closed. There have been times when That type of shot has snuck through the legs of Roman Turek. But he has played extremely well in this series, and going down to the other end to Evgeny Nabokov. You know, tonight, Dave, he's really coming out far and challenging the St. Louis shooters, and that's great if the guy shoots. I think the Blues may recognize that he's challenging a little further than the top of the paint there. And if they can get another teammate driving to the side of the net, take the fake shot, freeze Nabokov, and slide that across, it'll be an empty netter for a St. Louis Blue forward.
He'll face off deep in the Blues zone, and Eastwood, the best Blues face-off man all year, won that one. Ragnarsson could not hold it in, and it picked up a two-on-one to Valentin. Stillman mishandles the puck. He had Eastwood all alone, cutting toward the San Jose goal. Mellaby for the Blues. Well, maybe that ice is a factor. Eastwood tried to set it up there for Mellaby. Good job by Mateau defensively in his own zone. Markman's pass deflected by McGinnis, recovered by the Blues and cleared back into the San Jose zone. And this is going to be an icing call on the touch-up by Markman. And one of the guys that deserves credit for the play of the San Jose goaltenders is the coach, Warren Strelo, standing by with Chris Simpson.
Thanks, Dave. Warren, three of your prize students are making huge impacts in the playoffs this season with Johan Hedberg in Pittsburgh and, of course, Nabokov and Kiprizov here in San Jose. Are you surprised these guys are doing so well under such great pressure?
No, I'm not. They're very good athletes, all three of them. They've worked very, very hard all year to prepare themselves for this. And good athletes always rise to the occasion in the playoffs, and the cream comes to the top. And all three have done that, and I'm very proud of them.
Now, Kiprizov and Nabokov, you've watched them both all season long. Were you at all surprised Nabokov got the start today?
Well, John was injured, and he came back, and we worked yesterday for a half an hour on the rink, and he went through all the situations and did very well and didn't seem to have any pain, and we were just trying to wait to see if he, you know, tightened up after, but he didn't, and he's playing extremely well today.
Well, let's keep watching him. Thanks, Warren.
Thank you very much.
Guys.
All right, Chris, thanks very much. And here's Jamal Mayers at an angle. That's a good point, because there's been speculation as to exactly what the injury was with Nabokov. And whatever, whether it was a back or a knee or a shoulder or the flu, as it was stated, he has shown no ill effects the way he has played here this afternoon.
Well, let's start something else. Let's say he's holding out. He wants more money. And he wasn't going to play in the playoffs unless he got a bigger contract next year. So we'll throw that little rumor into the mix, folks.
No.
Take whichever one of the four you want.
Here's Jamal Mayers. Winds up, drives a shot to Bonkoff. Right pad save. And it's back the other way for Marco Sturm. Sturm has some speed. Crisscrossing with Nolan. Nolan winds up, drives a shot. Saved by Turek. By far his best save this afternoon. Let's go back to the studio. John Saunders and John Davidson.
And the Dodge Different update. L.A. dominating Detroit. Robitaille to Boulanger to LaPerriere. 2-0.
Bad coverage defensively. Larionov lost. Boulanger, LaPerriere with a tap-in. What a great move by the rookie Boulanger. Man, Detroit standing around. Osgood's been their best player.
That's why they tell you to crash the net, right? 2-0.
All right, thanks very much, guys.
I'll tell you what, this is a guy you want shooting, Owen Nolan, as he step into this one, and what a tremendous save by Roman Turek.
Incidentally, the last time the Detroit Red Wings won the first two games of a series at home and then lost was in 1993 against the Toronto Maple Leafs, when a guy named Felix Potvin was the goaltender. And Felix has been a big reason for the turnaround in that series that we just saw the highlights from Joe Louis Arena. Shot by Don Boos. Well wide after a deflection. Here's Stewart with it, bouncing it toward the St. Louis goal. Now down boost for Owen Nolan. That hit the goalposts, as we could hear, as Turek had the short side cover. Now Ragnarsson, a little trouble handling the puck, gets it ahead for Nolan. Nolan tries to poke it through Chris Pronger. Pronger tied him up well. Comes back for Scott Young, hands it off now for Turgeon, but he could not control. Down goes for the Sharks. Backhand pass out of the reach of Marco Sturm. And both teams will look to make line changes. 4.5 minutes have elapsed here in the second period. Scoreless game six so far. Markman hands it off now for Ragnarsson. And Ragnarsson, long outlet pass, Ricci. Little touch pass there for Nicholas Sundstrom. His shot right through. bumps off the pad of Turek. Sundstrom sends it in deep. Sean Hill for the Blues. Trying to clear. Dimitra. Checked by Jeff Norton. That puck still deep in the Blues' end. Now Tkachuk makes a nice play to Reacher, but it's broken up by Brian Markman. Back the other way. Sundstrom on the counterattack. Sundstrom with a wrist shot that deflects wide. Norton digs it free again. Sundstrom back to Jeff Norton. Norton lobs it toward the net.
Oh, man. Reaching
to the ice. He is shaken up on the play. Ricci's going to try to get back up. Boy, he hit the ice hard on his back. Here is Sundstrom with it. Back to the point. Jeff Norton, a shot through a crowd. Didn't get all the way through to it. And Havanoff. Havanoff is down, and he is hurt.
It was payback from Mike Ricci. Initially, it was Ricci knocked to the ice. The point shot came in. I believe it may have hit Ricci in the head area, so he was a little off balance. Then he was thrown to the ice by a Blue defender. And that was payback right there on Alexander Havanoff. I'll tell you what, Mike Ricci may well have gotten away with one there, and he knows it.
He's looking up to see if they're going to show it here in the building, because
you're darn right. He's at the bench saying, please don't show that replay. Of course, the officials can't make a call looking at a replay on a penalty like that. But you see right there the collision in front of the net. That was Sean Hill that leveled Mike Ricci as the puck was coming in from the blue line. And Mike Ricci, reeling from the hit, comes in and boom, the glove and or butt end to the face of Alexander Havanoff. And there goes with the shot block, first of all. So you've got the knee involved with the shot block, and then you've got the rifle to the face. So a tough couple of seconds for the defenseman of the St. Louis Blues, Havanoff.
Well, he will be, as you see, helped off the ice and not putting any weight on his right side.
So it is more the effect of the shot that stung Alexander than the collision with Mike Ricci.
So no penalties as a result of that exchange, and we've got 14:35 on the clock here in the second period.
A better pace to the second period,
yes,
than that of the first. Both teams coming out skating, especially the San Jose Sharks. They seem to have picked up their level of intensity and their speed to start the second period.
Salvador from behind his own net under some pressure from Marleau. Puck is knocked away, and Solani could not get control. McGinnis hands it off now for Mellenby. Mellenby had it knocked away, and it's cleared by Solani. Salvador waiting for his teammates to get onside. Makes a nice play. Steps up, got a shot off. Now Mellenby sends it across, and Stubman with a backhander. A save made by Nabokov. Mellenby put his hands in the air. He saw the puck disappear and thought perhaps the Blues had a goal. But that is not the case.
Well, Mellenby was perhaps sure. Nabokov wasn't sure where that puck was. And once again, it's the speed, the good attack. Stillman coming in. Evgeny Nabokov knows it's under him somewhere, but is it over the goal line? Hard to tell, hard to tell. It was actually the skate,
yes,
the follow through of Stillman skating through the crease, and that was not a kicking motion, folks. So had that puck gone into the net, that goal would have counted.
Corey Stillman with a great chance goes to the bench. His playoff career, first time he's been in the playoffs, Corey Stillman, since his rookie year with the Calgary Flames back in 96, when he played a couple of games against the Chicago Blackhawks that year. Here is Ricci. Backhanding it deep into the blue zone. Turek comes up, takes a look, lays it up the right wing boards. Corso now to Jochen Hesch, and Hesch gets it in deep. Brad Stewart trying to protect the puck. It comes free, a chance. Oh, Jamal Bears hit the goal post. Jamal Bears still looking for his first ever playoff goal. Bunger turns and sends it back behind the San Jose goal. Marleau to Solani. And Solani, second, third effort, finally clears the zone. Bunger with it, and he just dumps it down the ice. This should be icing here on the touch-up by Brad Stewart. Evgeny Nabokov has been sharp, and the St. Louis Blues trying to figure out a way to solve it. Scoreless with 13:17 to go in the second.
He's down, and it's going to be Jamal Mares. He beats Nabokov, but he can't beat the goalpost.
Hannon shot got through, save Turek. Marco Sturm driving the net. Now Nolan. Owen Nolan with a goal and an assist in the series, but both those points came in the game four victory. So the Sharks captain without a point in four of the five games. Here is Young getting it deep.
Play it, Abby, play it.
Now to Bakuk for Rachi. Rachi clears it ahead. Now Nolan from center right drives one over the head of Turek. Ducks out of the way. Now Danfus with it. Hands it off for Nolan. Nolan in traffic, battling against Dallas Drake. Ambroise Salvador. Salvador tries to clear. Rachi moves in from the point. Salvador again. And that puck rolls out to center ice. Ratsy's little flip pass. He was waiting for Nolan to get onside. Intercepted Young up the left side. Turgeon fakes. Tries to set it up for Dallas Drake. And it bounced in wide as the Bakuk got a skate on it. Back the other way now comes Tony Granato. Granato shot deflected just wide of Turek. Now Lindsay sends it deep. Danfus still out there. Centering attempt hit the back of the net. Picked up by Granato. And Danfus tried to send it across for an open net chance. And it was broken up by the Blues. Back the other way, Pavel Demitra. Ran into his own teammate as he wanted to cut to the front of the net. Demitra with a steal on the clearing attempt. Pavel Demitra behind the San Jose goal. Marchman trying to stay with him. Demitra has it again. Intercepted by Lindsay, who hands it off down for Granato, and he'll dump it in. He did not get to the red line. This is going to be an icing call. For four decades, one program has brought you the athletes and events that have become etched in popular culture. The thrill of victory and the agony of defeat. ABC's Wide World of Sports 40th anniversary special presented by Aflac next Sunday at 4 Eastern, 3 Pacific.
Communication between a goaltender and his defenseman is absolutely critical in the National Hockey League. And listen to this, folks.
Play it, Navi, play it!
Play it, Navi, play it! Mike Rathje with the yell. The Bakuk with a good outlet pass. And the San Jose Sharks, because of that communication, were on the attack.
25-year-old Evgeny Nabokov from Kazakhstan. We're at the Compact Center here in San Jose for game six of this Western Conference quarterfinal series. Dave Strader, Jim Schoenfeld, Christine Simpson. We heard Christine Simpson talk to Warren Strelow, the goaltending coach for the San Jose Sharks. Kiprasov was actually drafted ahead of Nabokov back in 94. And Nabokov has emerged as the number one goaltender right now. Now Mellenby could not get it out of the zone. Ragnarsson shot, though, did not get through, and it's cleared back the other way. Here is Corey Stillman with it. His quick shot, Nabokov steers it to the boards. Now Stillman sends it along on the near side, and Stefan Matteau for the Sharks is there. Jochen Hecht on the far side for the Blues. Brad Stewart with a big hit. Hest is going to get up. He's going to be okay. Both officials saw it. No call is made, and Hest can't believe it. This is offside at the Blues line.
Well, Jochen Hest bleeding from the forehead, the nose.
Wow.
It's a hit from behind. How could it not be called? Very dangerous play in the National Hockey League. Running your opponent from behind when he really can't defend himself. And right there, Brad Stewart with a huge hit. And then the extra little shove to drive the face into the boards as Jochen Hecht is falling to the ice. Both referees looking on, neither one of them having the presence of mind to make that call. And I think that's a terrible miss by the official, something I think should be called every time it occurs on the ice.
Well, they have been very diligent on that during the course of the season, and we've seen a couple of them called here in this playoff series. Now the puck knocked down by Matteau, and that play offside at the San Jose line.
Ray Brilli doing the mending job, stop the bleeding on Jochen Hecht. And what a great job the trainers in the National Hockey League do for their players. These guys are tireless workers. They travel to the city. They help the equipment guys set up. They get to their hotel rooms about 3, 4 in the morning. Then they're at the arena early, before practice, two and a half, three hours sometimes to provide treatments to the players that are injured. These guys are overworked, underpaid, and underrated as far as their contribution to the success of the respective hockey teams.
May have been Jochen Hesch, his own face shield, that may have hit the glass and then hit the nose, but that could have very easily been a 5-minute major and a 5-minute power play for the Blues.
Yeah, it was his own face shield, but the face shield didn't turn around and smack him. It was the face shield being driven into the glass.
Exactly.
Then coming back and hitting him. At least a 2-minute boarding penalty, and you're right, at the most it could have been a 5-minute boarding penalty. So Brad Stewart got away with one there, and he's had himself a darn good playoff series. Another one of the young San Jose Shark defensemen. We've mentioned Scott Hanna. What a fine job they have done, especially considering the absence of veteran Gary Suter. What a big loss that has been to the San Jose Sharks, especially on their power play.
Face off to the right of Evgeny Nabokov, in case you joined us late. Did not dress the last two games, but in the lineup tonight, here's Gusev with a drive. Right pad save made by Nabokov. And now Hannon with it. Nice little tip off the board by Solani, but an effort by Ricci is what clears the zone. Here comes Matteau. Matteau, centering pass, and it's wide of the far post. Krafcsy holding it in. Kicks it along for Ricci. In the corner now, Matteau for Solani. Solani behind Lynette. It came right out in front, but Dallas Drake was there. Scott Young pass broken up by Ricci. Just off the bench, Marco Sturm plays it now for Solani. He has spun around. Pronger trying to clear. Dallas Drake driven by Dom Boost. And Krafcsy for the Sharks clears it again. Lead pass now, Nolan for Dom Boost. Back for Owen Nolan. Pronger stood up and made the play defensively. Marty Reisner for the Blues. Still a scoreless game and past the halfway mark of period two. Here comes a chance for the Blues. Left skate save by Nabokov, and he hangs on as Tkachuk and Dom Boost. Oh, and Owen Nolan. No indication yet that there's going to be a penalty. These officials giving every indication that they're going to let these guys play. It is scoreless here in game six.
Second period. Keith Tkachuk's going to have a little face rub right there. And then he's Dom Boost, and then Owen Nolan coming in for the intercept. And that is not the first time that Nolan and Tkachuk have met. Nolan attempting the body check, and Tkachuk with the glove to the face, taking all the impact away from Owen Nolan and giving a little bit back to him before he arrived.
Let's go back to John Saunders and John Davidson.
And this Dodge different update. How good has the power play of Washington been? Sergei Gonchar with this goal.
Connor Walchuk right in front of the net sets up the screen. Here's the blast. It's in behind Hedberg. How about this? One even strength goal by Washington in the series. Six on the power play. It's keeping them alive.
And that even strength goal was the overtime winner by Halperin. 2-1.
All right, John and John, thanks very much. Nabokov thought about going out to play. The puck comes to Dimitrov. Saved Nabokov. Oh, Nabokov changed his mind at the last second. And boy, it's a good thing he did.
It was a great read by Evgeny Nabokov. Attempted to leave the cage, thought better of it. And Pavel Dimitra, who has been silent in this series, stymied once again by Evgeny Nabokov. Nabokov, should I get it? No, back to the net, Tkachuk on the hustle, the good pass. And that's a great look at it from our friends at Southwest Airlines, brought to you by their goal cam.
Pavel Dimitra had 16 shots in the first five games of the series, still looking for his first goal. Remember, his absence last year because of the post-concussion was looked at as a big reason why the Blues were knocked out by the Sharks in that first-round upset last year.
Well, early in the series, it looked like he had another concussion because he was run over by
Owen Nolan,
so he may be still suffering some of the effects of that hit.
Now back to get it is Nolan. Clears it out of his zone, down through center ice. Lead pass looking for Marco Sturm, but the Blues get there, and Pronger clears it out to center ice. Pronger again just inside the blue line. Intercepted by Dom Boost, trying to make a play, sends it across for Nolan. Nolan from the point, his shot was blocked, and it's cleared by the Blues. Corey Stillman, who had a great scoring chance earlier in the game. Here's Dimitra, shot was blocked by Jeff Norton. Cleared the other way. Sharks trying to come with some speed, but it's nearly broken up. Now it is by McGinnis. Good second effort by the Blues defenseman. Now for Mellaby. Don Harvey steps into him. And now Brad Stewart steps into Mellaby. The Blues have it, though. It comes out. Chance for Salvador. Saved by Nabokov. Here is McGinnis again through a crowd. It's in the glove of the Sharks goaltender, and he hangs on.
Dave, I think the Blues have to start shooting to the side of Evgeny Nabokov. He is challenging, well out of the top of the crease. He's very aggressive in goal. And when he comes way out like that, there's nothing to shoot at. That shot has to go cross seam for a tip in front. Or one of the Blue forwards has to spin off and try to get a tip from the side. Scott Mellaby is saying, man, oh man, I thought we had one there. Close, but still a donut, Scott.
Scott Mellaby was robbed by Kiprasov several times in game four. That deflected point shot went over top of the net. Another chance save, Nabokov. And the puck is cleared by Scott Thornton. How about Buffalo leading 6-0 over Philadelphia? And the LA Kings looking to win their third straight against Detroit, up 2-0. Stepping up now, Al McGinnis. Sends it back the other way, wanted to hit Scott Young. Nabokov comes out of the net to play it along the glass. Dallas Drake gets a glove on it. Checked right away by Nicholas Sundstrom. Now Ricci with it, and it bounces out to center ice. Salvador hands it off. They try to redirect it for Young. He had to slow down. Wristing it in behind Nabokov. Nabokov hands it off now for Rathje. Mike Ricci backhanding it over the head of the Blues defense, and that will be wide of Turek's net and will be an icing call.
0-0 score. You start wondering who's going to get the first goal, which in this game may be the last goal. And certainly Scott Thornton has scored some big goals in his playoff career. We go back to last year. He's not a Shark. The Dallas Star eliminating the San Jose Sharks. Game two of this series. 1-0 game. Who got the game winner? Scott Thornton with the only goal. And his third of this series in game four over the shoulder of Roman Turek. So wondering who's going to score the first goal, maybe the last goal of this game. Both goaltenders playing so well, we may be locked in to a long one, Dave.
Leading goal scorer in the series, as you see, for San Jose, Scott Thornton. What a job by Evgeny Nabokov. As you mentioned, Jim, the pace of the second period much higher than what we saw in the first. Now it comes to Jeff Norton. Norton to center ice. Pushing it ahead, it's knocked away by Pronger. Oh, it's Solani trying to get going. Upended there. Crowd wanted a penalty, but nothing coming. Gusrov for the Blues starts it back the other way. Jamal Mayers sends it ahead. Daniel Corso with some speed. Marchment with a big hit on him. You can tell Marchment, though, is not 100%. Now Jochen Hesch steps up, overskates the puck, penalty coming, and it's going to go against San Jose. It's going to be a roughing call, and it's going to go against defenseman Jeff Norton. So the St. Louis Blues in a scoreless game are going to get a power play because of that play by Jeff Norton. San Jose may be playing a bit with fire because you go back to the start of the third period in the overtime. The last 30 minutes of that game the other night, Jim, they were outshot 20-5. And the pace of this second period's better, but it's really been St. Louis that's been generating the chances 5-on-5, and now they get another power play.
Once again, it's the Blues against Nabokov in goal, and he, of course, is doing a great job. But you're right, you are playing with fire, and I'm sure this is not a message from the coaching staff. Very few National League coaches tell their teams to sit back.
Backhanded just wide as Young and Turgeon were breaking in, and Owen Nolan sends it down the ice.
Even with a 1 or 2 goal lead, you say establish a strong forecheck. Play as much of this period as we can in the offensive zone. If you make a mistake in the offensive zone.
Here's Nolan, a wraparound shorthanded, loose puck.
As I was about to say, if you make a mistake in the offensive zone, your opponent still has to make a couple of good plays, come all the way down the ice before they get a scoring chance. We just witnessed a mistake in the defensive zone, and that quickly results in a scoring chance. And it's McGinnis with the giveaway. Good intercept right there by Ononi. Tries to wrap around. Connor prevents it, and then driving to the net. I believe that was Sundstrom or Hannon. We'll have to get a look at the number here. I think it's defenseman Scott Hannon coming in, and the puck is there. It's there, and he can't get a stick on it. My goodness. He'll be seeing that for the rest of the summer. The San Jose Sharks should not win this game. Oh. There it is. He's reaching, and he just misses it. Great recovery by Al McGinnis and Roman Turek. And that's what happens with a mistake in the D zone.
McGinnis now recovering the puck behind the St. Louis goal. Sharks have given it away 10 times, the Blues 7, and McGinnis from center ice. Well, behind the net, here was Corey Stillman for the Blues, trying to set it up for Mellenby. Back to Stillman. In the corner, Mellenby again. Rolling it in for Jochen Hest. Hest behind the net, center, Hest score! Power play goal! Corey Stillman drove it home. It is 1-0 St. Louis.
Well, you may think this was a bad penalty for Jeff Norton to take, but the way the game was being called and the things that were allowed, it was just another push. The penalty was called, and right here, the payoff. Mellenby behind the net. The pass is going to come right out front. Great motion coming to the front of the net. Corey Stillman pays it off for the St. Louis Blues. Jochen Hest, the good look, the short side pass from the backhand. And Stillman with the good speed coming. Nabokov almost had it. Nabokov was in motion. May have got a piece of that shot with his glove. But nonetheless, with 4.5 minutes remaining in the second period, the St. Louis Blues have themselves a 1-0 lead.
Stillman's second goal of the series, his third career playoff goal. Jochen Hest will get one assist. And after that great shorthanded bid by the San Jose Sharks, the Blues have scored first. Lead pass for Ricci. Pronger gets back, hammers it off the glass. It doesn't come out. Dallas Drake gets it back from Scott Young. Here comes Drake on the backhand save, Nabokov. Big save there to keep it 1-0. Now Ricci trying to get through Gusarov. Pronger, though, coming over to help out. Here's the fifth partner. Here come the Blues. A breakaway chance for Dimitra to the forehand. He scores! Pavel Dimitra, his first goal of the playoffs this year. How did two St. Louis Blues get behind the Sharks' defense?
Good time right now for Daryl Sutter to maybe call a timeout and settle his troops down. And we talked about the silence of Dimitra. Keith Tkachuk very alertly on the line change with a pass. And what a move, forehand shot past Evgeny Nabokov. And what a quick, dramatic turn of events in the last couple of minutes for the St. Louis Blues.
A 2-0 St. Louis Blues lead. The goals coming just 52 seconds apart. As Stillman sends it across in front of Nabokov. Owen Nolan is there. Hands it off now for Jeff Norton. So a team that struggles to score goals, that average less than three during the regular season, needs three at least to win this game. And Roman Turek able to hang on.
Dave, 8 of St. Louis's 15 goals have been scored by players that were not on last year's playoff roster. And Dallas Drake leads that charge with 4. And Dimitra, although he was a St. Louis Blue, did not play last year. So you could probably add another one, make that 9 of the 15 goals scored by the Blues. And terrific effort by Dimitra. Stillman, a power play goal, and we keep saying you're playing with fire when you give the St. Louis Blues a lot of power play opportunities. And a great point by you. A team that has a hard time scoring goals has to get 3 with 23 minutes remaining in the hockey game.
And a face-off here deep in the Blues zone. So you're right, Corey Stillman not on the roster until just before the trade deadline, and Pavel Dimitra was not here for that entire first round upset because of his injury. Shot from the point, deflected right through, and Nolan just failed to get a stick on it. It comes to Turgeon, and Turgeon able to clear for the St. Louis Blues. Norton pokes it ahead. Tom Foose now put it behind Nolan. It's intercepted by Pronger. Pronger now for Turgeon. He is drilled by Marchman, who stood him up in the neutral zone. Let's see if that ignites the San Jose Sharks, but this play is offside. Well, let's get to our Valvoline storyline here this afternoon. Valvoline Max Light. Dimitra, first goal of the series. Stillman, a power play goal. And there you see the workload of the two goaltenders.
Such a fine line between winning and losing in the National Hockey League. Score is 0-0 right here, folks. And Scott Hannon just cannot get his stick on the puck. Moments later, the Blues score. They take a one-goal lead. Then Tkachuk to Dimitra. And it's a 2-0 St. Louis Blue lead. Had Hannon been able to find the handle on that puck, 1-0 Sharks and perhaps 2-0 Sharks. So just like that, which could have been a Shark lead, ends up being a 2-goal St. Louis Blue lead. Amazing how things can turn so quickly in the National Hockey League.
2 goals, did you see, in 52 seconds, and Turek able to stop that blast, gave up a rebound, but it comes back to the point. Scott Hannon bouncing it wide of the St. Louis goal. Bryce Salvador able to clear it back the other way, but it ends up in the bench and out of play.
We know that Brian Marchman is not 100% today, but he is a warrior, folks. And if Brian Marchman can find a way to get the job done, he will get it done. And boom, there is a great open ice hit on Pierre Turgeon. And believe me when I tell you, Marchman is a great body checker. Pierre Turgeon, one of the most solid players in the National Hockey League, on his feet. This guy's rock hard. You walk by him, you say, how you doing, Pierre? And you tap him on the shoulder.
Yep.
What a great athlete. What a tremendous playoff he is having. And a great asset to the St. Louis Blue organization.
That shot is blocked as it rolls all the way back through center ice. Pierre Turgeon, one of the most consistent performers in the National Hockey League. His 13th straight 20-goal season this year. Second only to Brett Hull's streak of 14 straight. Mellamy ducks under most of that Todd Harvey hit. Goaltender Turek doesn't have a stick. Bryce Salvador tried to give it to him, and he said, I got to go back and play the pocket. And we got a penalty coming as Hannon goes back.
Salvador had to drop that stick, Dave. Had he played the puck, the puck came right to Bryce Salvador. Had he played it with his stick in his hand and also the goaltender's stick in his hand, it is a penalty.
Well, Dean Warren, a little problem with the microphone, but interference is the call against Todd Harvey.
And that's once the goaltender loses his stick, it's being kicked away. You see right here, Turek's going to let the puck go. This is not the penalty. The stick will be picked up by the defenseman. Bryce Salvador is going to bring it back. And right now the puck's coming to Salvador. He's got to let go. He can't play the puck with the stick. And as Turek goes to pick up the stick, it is kicked out of the way by Todd Harvey. That is interference, folks. That's the penalty that was called. And a very alert call by the official.
And so the St. Louis Blues go on the power play once again. And Todd Harvey says, nope, that wasn't intentional. I was just skating through there.
That was very alert thinking by Bryce Salvador to let that stick drop from his hand. And the reason I know that so well, folks, when I was a Detroit Red Wing, I did the same thing. I went to retrieve the stick for the goaltender. The puck came right to me. I couldn't help but play it. Touched my stick, the whistle blew, and I sat out the next 2 minutes in the penalty box. So I know what I'm talking about on this one, folks, I tell you.
Puck comes back to Scott Hannon now inside the Shark zone, and Hannon hammers it the other way, but it's stopped by Tkachuk. So the St. Louis power play last year scored at least once in all 7 games, and they have scored now in 4 of the 6 games. Well, the goal here this afternoon, Novakov plays it to the boards. It's picked up though by Owen Nolan, and Nolan hands it off now for Hannon. Hannon takes it into the blue zone, sends it deep. Owen Nolan has it there. Good defensive play by Sean Hill. And now Tkachuk trying to send it across, intercepted by Nolan. Nolan again run into by Sean Hill. And Pronger with it now from behind his own net. Gets it ahead now for Pierre Turgeon. Turgeon's pass just out of the reach of Hill. Brad Stewart for San Jose jumps up. Could not get it around Turgeon. Now Stewart able to hammer it deep into the blue zone. As you see the time remaining in the period. And just a bit more time than that on the penalty to Todd Harvey. McGinnis is head up all the way. Now Pronger puts it in deep. Rankerson is back there for the shorthanded Sharks. Brad Stewart tries to clear. Sundstrom could not get it out of there. Now it is back to the right point. McGinnis teams up for the pass and is blocked by Rankerson. And recovered by Sundstrom. He clears. Now it comes to Jochen Hesch. Hesch able to dump it along behind the Bakhtov. Skipping puck, and Turek had to be careful with that. And that's going to do it for the second period, which featured two goals by the Blues, one by Stillman and one by Dimitro. The Dodge Different Intermission Report with John Saunders and John Davidson is coming up next. The Blues with a 2-0 lead, and we'll be back with the intermission report after these messages and a word from our ABC stations. They have to go to work 5-on-5. They've got to start taking a few chances and create some opportunities. As you see, the St. Louis Blues just one loss all year when leading after two. San Jose has been able to come back and win seven times when they've trailed, but so far in this series, the Blues, when they've had the lead after two periods, a perfect 2-0. Dallas Drake dumps it in. And here is Hannon with it now. Hannon outlet pass for Sundstrom. Bouncing puck, Ricci trying to get control. It's knocked away by Salvador. And dumped back into the blue zone. McGinnis back to get it. Sharks back at full strength. Here comes Dimitri. Lost his edge there at center ice. Reisner tapped it into the San Jose zone. Reisner and Sundstrom get tied up. Now Dimitri rolling it back in deep for Keith Tkachuk. He made the great pass on the Dimitri goal. Now a diving play by Brad Stewart to cover the puck with a glove. Jumps right back up and fights off Tkachuk to clear it out to center right. McGinnis lifts it too high. It goes over the glass and out of play.
Well, Dave, it was a scoreless tie in the second period when Owen Nolan hit the post, and then Scott Hannon came in from the blue line and just could not get a stick on him moments later. Defeat from Hesch to Corey Stillman, 1-0 Blues. Tkachuk to Pavel Demitra, 2-0 St. Louis. They bring that two-goal lead into the third period. This is a situation where Joel Quenneville will be just rolling his lines. Four lines, keep the shift short, keep up the pressure. On the other side, Daryl Sutter's going to have to shorten his bench. He's got to come up with probably his 9 or 10 best offensive forwards and give them a lion's share of ice time in this third period.
10 of the Blues' goals in this series scored by players that weren't on the roster last year, and that's what Larry Plo and Joel Quenneville had set out to do, is make this team more playoff ready. That's how Pat Quinn described his Toronto Maple Leafs when they struggled down the stretch during the regular season. Said they were more prepared for the playoffs, and they showed it against Ottawa. It is a 2-0 Blues lead looking to wrap up this first round series. Ratsy backhand pass, dangerous one, hit the helmet. Now it's picked up by Hesch. The players lost the helmet earlier in the shift. Solani shot. Goes wide of the net. Jamal Mayers run into by Todd Harvey, and the puck back the other way. Daniel Corso for the Blues. Hooked off the puck there by Mateau. Now Todd Harvey back to get it. Harvey from out of his own zone. Long pass center ice over the glove of Mateau, and this is going to be an icing call on the touch-up by Al McGinnis. Let's go downstairs. Christine Simpson.
Well, guys, backs to the wall. The season's on the line. Whatever cliche you want to use, now would be the time to use it with less than 20 minutes to go in this game. This packed house of Sharks fans ready to explode if the Sharks give them something to cheer about. Now, their team was able to pull off a miracle last season. Will they be able to do it again?
Well, not a lot of confident faces there, Chris. Thanks very much.
The first shot was a hungry fan.
Yeah, yeah,
that's right. And the other one was, she wasn't really quite interested.
Now, one of the things I wanted to ask you about was a noon start here local time, how that affects players, whether it matters at this time of year. You hear so much talk about body clocks and things like that. You're used to playing at 7:30 at night. As Salvador's shot is deflected wide by Nabokov.
Same for both teams, really should not be a factor in the game, Dave.
Salvador for the Blues, tries to play it back. Would have been offside had the Blues touched it. It was waved off. And now Domfus, backhanding it deep into the blue zone. Now McGinnis for St. Louis. And Scott Young. Young plays it ahead. Salvador from center ice fires it in wide of Nabokov. Now it comes to Domfus. Domfus sends it across into the blue zone. Sharks were changing, so Pronger not under any pressure there to make that clearing pass. Now here is Jeff Norton. He took the penalty that led to that first Blues goal on the power play. Now Tkachuk winds up. What's the shot go? He wanted to one-time it. Oh, Nabokov got away with using his goal stick on Marty Riesner. Cutting through the crease. And Solani has it now. Marlowe with speed going to the net. Solani makes a move. Solani winds up. Drives the shot. Save rebound. Marlowe with a save by Turek. Oh, Roman Turek has not had to face many bang-bang opportunities, stopping one shot and then a rebound in this game here this afternoon.
He sure hasn't had to face many Teemu Selänne slappers in this series. Nice to see Teemu finally unleash one.
Jeff Norton gets in there deep, joining the rush. Now the puck comes free, though. Eastwood tries to hand it off for Mellamy, does not connect. And Archman tried to draw the icing call, but it won't be called there. Cross ice for Nicholas Sundstrom, tipped away by Salvador. Marchman comes in, puts a hit onto Mellenby as the puck comes free, and Cannon for the Sharks back to get it. Cannon off the boards. It's deflected by Scott Thornton, could not get it into the blue zone. Cannon for the Sharks again, plays it ahead, Salvador. Just drives it right back. Jochen Hesch, who took that hit into the boards in the second period, but took a couple of stitches and appears to be all right. Now Ratsy from the red line. Puts it in softly. Turek back there to settle it down. And now Pronger. Snaps the outlet pass. Jamal Mayers hands it off. Corso burst to speed. Now to Hesch to shot. He missed the net on the short side. And Hannon back the other way. Hannon gets it into the blue zone. Both teams making changes. Errol Sutter comes out with Todd Harvey. Bill Lindsay. Tony Granato to try to get something going. Granato bumping with Jochen Hecht away from the puck. And now here comes Lindsay with it. Lindsay had it poked off of his stick. It's recovered by Marcus Ragnarsson. He dumps it deep into the blue zone. Alice Drake. What a series he has had. Leading goal scorer in the series with four. Coming into this afternoon, a steal here by the Sharks, but the Blues got it right back. Boucherov plays it up the far boards, and you can hear the collision as the puck rolls back into the San Jose zone. Brad Stewart has it. Leap pass chopped down by Domfus, and Turek steals it to the corner. Here's Domfus again, but Pronger knocks it away. Now McGinnis, rink-wide pass, Tkachuk with speed, gets by Stewart, Tkachuk, and he never could settle the puck down and get the shot away. What a burst of speed by Keith Tkachuk. Here's McGinnis with a drive to mark off the save. Another one backhanded wide by Pavel Dimitra. Blues trying to keep the pressure on. One more goal would probably do it for them. Now Salvador racing to the red line. Drives it in across the San Jose zone. It is chipped out to the line, held in by Corey Stillman. Now Marchman knocks it away from his goaltender. Norton plays it along the boards, and Patrick Marleau able to clear. Blues drive it deep again. Mellenby in on Norton, and Jeff Norton able to keep his balance. Long outlet pass for Solani. Recovered by Solani again, and Solani up into the St. Louis zone. Could not control. And it's cleared back the other way. And the puck will play with a high stick.
With the St. Louis Blues protecting a two-goal lead, Teemu Selänne is going to get a pretty good chance here. Roman Turek will make the save. Patrick Marleau with the rebound. Turek says, uh-uh. And a block off, and you see right here, he goes to the backhand, and the puck just bounces off his stick, and that was brought to you by the Southwest Airlines goal cam.
13 minutes straight up remaining in the third period. Is that the time remaining in this series? And therefore the San Jose Sharks season. They need to make something happen as the Blues got their two goals just 52 seconds apart late in period number two from Corey Stillman and then Pavel Dimitra. Chopped at by Solani. Turek directing traffic. Pronger has it now. And Pronger up the right wing side. He's checked on the play. Got by Marlowe. Doesn't get through. Bouncing puck. Centering pass. And Solani had a stick on the ice, but the puck didn't get there. Kucherov able to clear it back the other way. And Rathje will get there, but it will be an icing call. Let's go back to the studio. John Saunders, John Davidson.
LA Kings protecting a two-goal lead against Detroit, but 33 seconds in, Slava Kozlov will get the goal. Watch him on the doorstep, a little pokey in there, but then a minute and five later, LA comes back.
Look at Palfi, frees everybody, beautiful pass across, and all of a sudden, Detmar scores. It was a close game, then the Kings got another one back.
And this is as good as LA has looked in the playoffs.
Boy, what a difference in a team when they believe. And Brett Hull and the Stars believe they can eliminate the Oilers. The Oilers have other thoughts. You'll see it on ESPN's National Hockey Night, 7 Eastern, 4 Pacific. And what a turnaround on the Western Conference if the LA Kings upset the Detroit Red Wings. They would play Colorado in the next round. Whoa. You have Rob Blake, of course, going up against the team that traded him. And Adam Detmarsson was part of that trade, making the big play. Actually, it was Palfi that made the play, and Detmarsson getting the goal. A lot of time still to go. As McGinnis tries to clear, Marchman pinched up, and it comes down to Eastwood. Rink wide, that goes off the stick of Mellenby. Nicholas Sundstrom trying to find somebody open, and this will not be icing. So Don Booth will come back after Pronger, but Pronger got rid of the puck quickly.
The Blues are now playing zone hockey. As quickly as they can, they try to get the puck out over the blue line, out of the defensive zone, through the neutral zone, deep into the offensive zone, and then establish the forecheck. But look how quickly they will try to exit the D zone. One pass, anything near the blue line will go off the boards, an indirect pass. Make sure they're clearing the defensive zone, take their chance in the neutral zone. And if they can get it deep, they're trying to establish a strong forecheck. Very difficult for the Sharks to generate any offense against a team that plays defense as well as the St. Louis Blues.
Here is Tkachuk getting it in deep. Marcus Ragnarsson out from behind his own net. Long pass, and Dumpus tried to sweep it to Mateau, but it didn't get through, and Corso dumps it back in.
How quickly the Blues are going north-south. Very, very few east-west passes. That means left-to-right, folks, in the D-zone. Everything is straight ahead. Hit the head man. Follow the playoff.
Pass tries to set it up for Jamal Mayers, who was cutting for the net. It didn't get through, and it's recovered again by Jamal Mayers. Mayers' shot knocked up on the air and recovered by Rathje. Now to Solani. Teemu Solani with it. Center ice. Nice to hand it off from Marlowe. It's poked away by Salvador. And back comes Hannon. Hannon got some help from Marlowe, who got away with some interference. Now Hannon going wide. Tried to dump it in front. It was blocked.
Good play by Salvador on that one, Dave.
Here is Patrick Marlowe again. Tried to set up Bill Lindsay. Pitching down along the boards there was Rathje. Tried to chip it deep behind the net, looking for a centering attempt, but doesn't get through. Torek is down, taking everything away there. Dallas Drake, Jamal Mayers, could be a two-on-one. It goes to Jamal Mayers, top of the circle drive to Bakhov, the save. And here comes Hannon. He's been more aggressive offensively, but that pass broken up by Pronger. He just dumps it back into the San Jose zone. Now Todd Harvey with it. Harvey for Brian Marchman. Marchman gets it deep into the blue zone. First one back, Kucherov. Plays it off the board. Todd Harvey moves up. Couldn't control. Stillman outlet. 3-on-2 for the Blues here. Eastwood. Pass across in that play. Offside. And it is getting to be closer to crunch time for the Sharks. 9:07 to go in the third. Perhaps in their season, they trail 2-0. Welcome back to ABC's continuing coverage of the Stanley Cup playoffs from Compaq Center, home of the San Jose Sharks. The Blues lead the series 3-2, and they lead this game 2-0. Dave Strader, Jim Schoenfeld, Christine Simpson with you here. on a Saturday afternoon, and Daryl Sutter not happy with the way things have gone here this afternoon. And obviously his club, as we've mentioned before, that struggles to score, down by two, trying to generate something against the St. Louis team that during the course of the year gave up the fewest shots per game, one of the hardest teams to score against. Against a team that struggles to score is not the ideal matchup. Dillman putting it in deep. Nabokov takes a look. And Nabokov playing it up the boards. Eastwood is there. Eastwood is run over. Big hit on the far side by Marchman. Jeff Norton along the boards is checked there by Mellenby. Now it comes to Eastwood again. He's hit once more by Marchman. Now it comes to Marco Sturm, Owen Nolan. He was checked by Tkachuk. Nolan has it again. Hands it off for Sturm on the weave. Marco Sturm for Owen Nolan. Nolan trying to get through, but the Blues just won't let that happen. It's going to be very difficult to do anything on the rush for the San Jose Sharks. They're going to have to get it deep and get guys going.
And it's difficult to win one-on-one battles low against the defensive core of the St. Louis Blues, especially because Pronger and McGinnis will be on the ice most of this third period.
A steal by Thornton. He tried to go high, and Couric held his ground. And boy, the Sharks come close.
Bryce Salvador almost making it a little easier for Scott Thornton, but no goal because Couric, another good save.
Let's get to the original core storyline for our game here this afternoon on ABC. 10 of the 16 St. Louis goals scored by players that weren't here for the series last year. And the Sharks 0-4 on the power play.
And the best blue in the series, Dallas Drake, gets the shorthanded game winner. The feed from Scott Young, that was game three. And in game five, the blast from the blue line, Bryce Salvador. And tonight, the first goal of the game, Corey Stillman. Great additions. Larry Cole doing a terrific job keeping this team highly competitive in St. Louis.
Stewart's shot was blocked. It comes right back to him. Brad Stewart tries to send it through. And Pierre Turgeon is there.
Larry Poole, of course, is the general manager of the St. Right. Louis Blues. This is a second 100-plus point regular season.
Now it comes again to Thornton. Rolling it in deep, Gusarov. Thornton gets in there again. Sundstrom behind the St. Louis net. Nicholas Sundstrom looks down for Brad Stewart. Shot did not get through. Sundstrom one more time. In deep for Ricci. Ricci tries to wrap up. Stewart is out. He's gone.
San Jose Sharks gets the St. Louis Blues running around, and Mike Ricci from behind the net, the terrific pass, Nicholas Sundstrom blasts it past Roman Turek. This is the end of a great shift, and I'm sorry, it's Brad Stewart, not Nicholas Sundstrom. Brad Stewart with the goal. 2-1 hockey game with just over 7 minutes remaining here in the third period.
Here is Rathje. Lays it ahead now for Marlowe. Intercepted Corey Stillman back the other way with Mellenby. Stillman makes a move between the circles. Just hooked on the play. Drops it back. McGinnis, he gets a shot away that is blocked. And back comes Solani. There's still a lot of time left in this one, folks. And it's only a one-goal game. Here's Solani. Chips it ahead for Marco Sturm. Played back the other way, and Scott Hannon has it. And it rolls it across for Brian Marchman. Marchman's lead pass does not get through. Marchman struggling on his skate, but still makes the play. Here's Nolan with a chance, and it was deflected wide. Centering pass doesn't get through. Corso for the Blues. Along the board. It's bounced back in, and Turek has to make a save on Marco Sturm. Pronger with that great outlet pass of his. Ilkin Hesch could not get to it. Back comes Jeff Norton. Hands it off for Sturm. Sturm now for Nolan. Nolan lobs it to the net, deflected to the corner. It comes back to Nolan. He tried to go short side, and it deflected off the side of the net. Pronger went down, was looking for a call, nothing coming. Here comes Jeff Norton again, Don Foos. It's picked up at the side of the net now by Nolan. A nifty move on Pronger. Nolan plays it off the boards now for Brad Stewart. Stewart fakes one way, goes the other. Oh, it's right at the goal line, and cleared.
The Sharks pressing the Blues with nervous sticks here in the third period. Tremendous resilience by the San Jose Sharks. As we mentioned, folks, a team that will not quit.
Salvador reaching with a hit. But the Blues come out with it as Turgeon rolls it center ice. It was behind Scott Young. Ragnarsson sends it right back in. Sundstrom has it bounce off of his body, and it's recovered by Turgeon. Turgeon center zone, crisscrossing with Young. Young takes it deep behind the net. Ragnarsson wouldn't let him reverse his direction. Now Ricci trying to dig it out of there. And we get a whistle and a late shove there by Ricci. Boy, no need for that, but no call coming. The fans are back into it. Will that inspire the Sharks to another goal? Stay tuned and see. 80 minutes is why the fans still believe.
Mike Ricci, the nice feed to Brad Stewart. Stewart up over Roman Turek. Are the San Jose Sharks on the verge of coming back to tie this game in the third period? 5 minutes to go. Hang in there, folks, and find out.
First goal by the San Jose Defense Corps in this series. Only San Jose and LA did not have a goal from their defense coming into action here this afternoon. Now Stillman battling in there deep along with Eastwood. Behind the net, here is Stillman. Goes the other way, and Eastwood was tied up well by Ricci, one of the better defensive forwards in the National Hockey League. Gusarov. Handled off now Eastwood back into his own zone for Chris Pronger. Now for Eastwood again. Mellenby hit by Rapsy center ice. Puck recovered by Mateau. Intercepted by Tkachuk, and he'll just play it back to the San Jose blue line. 4 minutes, 20 seconds to go in regulation time. The Blues with a 2-1 lead. McGinnis with it. And that is knocked down by Mateau. Step by Mateau. Now McGinnis clearing it along the boards. Gusarov to Dimitra. He is checked on the play on the far side by Markman, who pitched in. Now Tkachuk making sure that he clears the zone. And Mateau shielding the puck away from Jochen Hecht. First goal in 90 minutes of play for the San Jose Sharks, going back to the goal by Patrick Marleau in game five. Here's McGinnis with it. Right side feed for Scott Young does not connect. This is going to be an icing call. We're going down to the wire here for an update. John Saunders and John Davidson.
Here's your WorldCom great save of the day. Chris Osgood has had a lot of work stopping Stumple here.
Well, LA was leading 3-1 at the time after that big save. You can see that the Chelios shot here finds its way in behind. Osgood makes a big save, and the Red Wings are alive.
So, like you guys, this one going down to the wire as well.
All right, John and John, thank you very much. 2.5 left in that one, and 3.5 left in this one. Nabokov on the left. Bit of a surprise that he might start here this afternoon after the job that Mika Kiprusoff had done, but as Jim Schoenfeld explained, Daryl Sutter felt that Nabokov's the guy that got us here. As long as he's healthy, he's going to get the nod, and nobody understood that more than Mika Kiprusoff. He was happy for the opportunity, but it's Nabokov's team, and this is going to be another icing against the St. Louis Blues.
The real shame is that one of these great goaltenders is going to lose this hockey game today, and if it's the San Jose Sharks, lose the series. Neither deserves to lose. They have been outstanding. That young man for the entire series, as he has played every minute for the St. Louis Blues, Roman Turek. And you look at that right there, one goal games, San Jose 4-1. Not so good for the Blues, the news. There's a look at Kiprusoff. Goaltending in this series has been just terrific. What do you expect that in the Stanley Cup playoffs? You don't advance unless your goaltender is on the top of his game, and you certainly don't win the Stanley Cup unless he's absolutely brilliant.
Puck is cleared back center ice. And here is Stillman. Corey Stillman snaps a shot. Nabokov, the save. Big rebound. Carries all the way out to the blue line, and the puck goes back into the St. Louis zone. Gusarov being chased by Nolan. Bonger did a good job slowing Nolan down. And the Blues able to clear. Owen Nolan with it. Drops it back now for Stewart. His pass does not connect with Ragnarsson. Under 3 minutes to go now. Scott Young, Gallo straight, cutting for the net. Young makes a move. Looking for Al MacInnis perhaps out at the line. That wasn't there, so he just sets it back in deep. Collision behind the net between Turgeon of the Blues and Todd Harvey of the Sharks. Sharks able to clear, but it's Al MacInnis that has it. He lifts it right back into the San Jose zone, and a quick call on the offside. Well, Keith Tkachuk in his long career has never been out of the first round of the playoffs. How would he feel about getting to round number two?
Conditions are a lot higher here. In Phoenix and Winnipeg, I think we're in a position where we're just happy to be there. And if we got out of the first round, that'd be a bonus. But here, you're expected to win. So if you don't get out of the first round, it's a huge disappointment. So I have a better chance of winning here. Obviously, this organization has done everything possible to make their team better. I feel like we can go a long way here.
Well, Keith Tkachuk maybe didn't get out of the first round, but his entire career with the Jets and the Coyotes, the team made the playoffs. Without him this year, they did not make the playoffs. So anybody that wants to lay a little blame on Captain Tkachuk, I think you're playing the blame in the wrong place.
Center ice, Todd Harvey directs it across now to Lindsay. And the Blues trying to cut off every lane into their defensive zone now as Dimitra. Able to chip it off the boards. 2 minutes straight up left here in the third. When will Novakov get the call to go to the bench? Puck is blocked by Salvador. Marchment battling against three St. Louis Blues. Ricci, you see, is there, and now it is blown dead.
1:48 on the clock. To Joel Quenneville, that seems like an eternity. To Darryl Sutter, not nearly enough time. He wants to see that clock move more slowly than it is. Take 4 or 5 seconds for 1 second to tick off, and he'll be getting the signal straight now when he wants the goaltender to come to the bench for the extra attacker. Scott Hannon looking on. Nicholas Sundstrom, Mike Ricci on the ice. Sundstrom, Thornton has been their best line throughout this playoff series. A great line on the forecheck.
Faceoff win comes back to Rafty. He drives it in on Torek. He settles it down, starts to come off. Ricci with a big hit. And it's recovered by Turgeon. He hands it off now for Scott Young. Young from center ice tries to flip it in. And that play just offside.
Oh. 1:34 to go. The Blues, an opponent of the San Jose Sharks. And now the clock, an opponent of the San Jose Sharks. Darryl Sutter looking up and down his bench. Trying to get it timed for that last minute to get his five best offensive people on the ice. And whenever there is a whistle, he'll be calling his timeout and resting those players and coming right back with him, plus the sixth extra attacker for the goaltender. And Darryl Sutter would love to have an offensive zone faceoff. That's the best time to get your goaltender out. You call your timeout, you get fresh troops on, everything starts in the offensive zone.
Sundstrom pushes it to the corner. Here is Pronger trying to clear. Bounces over the stick of Ricci, and it gets by Mike Rafty as well, the center ice. Ricci picks it up and sets it across, but it's kicked away by Gusarov. Now Hannon again rolls it across, but it's the Blues that get there first. Ricci again. Coming down toward 1 minute. Ricci lifts it high in the air. That's what they were looking for. Novakov going to the bench. Extra attacker on the ice. We've seen it in the playoffs this year. Team scoring with the extra attacker. Nolan with a shot that does not get through. Blues look to clear, and it's all the way down the ice. And it is going to be an icing call on the touch-up here by Stewart. So here comes the offensive zone faceoff. Jim Schoenfeld, that the Sharks were looking for.
This is where Darryl Sutter will call his timeout. I'm sure he'll wait and wait until the referees make their way over to the bench. And he'll finally say, yeah, I'm going to make the call here. He'll draw up a play, something that has been practiced throughout the regular season. Goaltender out, face-off won. Goaltender out, face-off lost. Where are we going to go? Clarify the assignments for the players. And maybe Darryl Sutter wants to hurry and get his players on so that Pronger and MacInnis are not rested for the St. Louis Blues. Timo Solani coming on the ice. The goaltender out. because of his silence in the series, because there are only five Blues and there are six Sharks. If San Jose is going to score a goal, look for Timo Solani to maybe be the guy to do it.
And we welcome those of you that have watched the Detroit Red Wings and the LA Kings. The Sharks have pulled their goaltender. They're down by a goal. They must tie the game to send it to overtime and extend the series. Stewart shot blocked. Here's a chance! And I don't think it got through to Turek. It may have been Chris Pronger that had the shot blocked. And it's cleared by the Blues wide of the open net. And it's touched by Brad Stewart.
Faceoffs, faceoffs, so critical. Game five was won with a faceoff victory for the Blues. Salvador rifling that one home. And game six was almost tied up as Vinny Dompoos wins this faceoff. Turek ready for the shot. It's coming, and it gets blocked in front, but there's Solani and Chris Pronger with a tremendous block off the stick of Timo Solani.
31 seconds. The concerned faces of the San Jose players on the bench and the focus of Roman Turek, and quickly blowing the whistle here. And the referee is coming over to the penalty timekeeper. I'm not sure.
The timekeeper put the seconds right back on.
Okay.
The seconds had ticked off, and before the referee arrived, the timekeeper, who's obviously a veteran, put the time right back on. That was a no-go in that draw. Eastwood against Dompoos. Who's going to win the battle? One more clear for the Blues could be all they need.
So it's Dompoos again for the Sharks. It is Eastwood for the Blues. Faceoff won by Dompoos. Back to Owen Nolan. Slides it across for Stewart. Stewart with a drive. Oh, Turek had that deflect off him and wide. It comes back to Stewart again. Sends it in deep for Solani. Eastwood, intercept for the Blues. It hits off the side of the net. Scott Young can't clear. 15 seconds remaining. Stewart a shot. Saved by Turek. Oh. Loose puck. A scramble. Oh, perhaps a save. Perhaps a save by Mike Eastwood. It comes back again. Dompoos with a drive. Oh, and what an ending to this game and this series.
The San Jose Sharks throw everything they possibly can at Roman Turek and the St. Louis Blues. Not enough to get the job done. Roman Turek exercising all of last year's playoff demons. Joel Quenneville, a great job with the St. Louis Blues. Daryl Sutter, a tremendous job. Cap Raider, the San Jose Sharks. And you talk about the thrill of victory, the agony of defeat. You can see it on the faces of these players. And what a dramatic finish. And Roman Turek and his defensemen paying the price and paying it off to the St. Louis Blues. A 2-1 victory in game six.
It may have been Mike Eastwood, the centerman, that got back behind his goaltender that made the save. And how about the weight lifted off the shoulder of Roman Turek? Many thought he was the main reason why the Blues were upset in the first round last year. His numbers outstanding in this first round.
Perhaps the main reason the Blues are advancing this year.
The great tradition in Stanley Cup playoff action, as hard as these two teams went at each other last year and went at it again this year. After it's all over, you shake hands, one team moves on, the other goes home to think about what might have been. So the Blues win the game 2-1 and win the series 3-2. For Jim Schoenfeld, I'm Dave Strader, and Christine Simpson, the rest of our ABC crew, thanks for joining us here in San Jose. The Sharks go home. The Blues move on to the second round of the playoffs. Now let's send it back to our ABC studios, John Saunders and John Davidson. Good afternoon.
And folks, we don't care who wins, but the two big guys here were both out of our chairs in the final seconds of that game.
It's just wild all over the place. I think Roman Turek, if you take the 16 teams going into the first round, there's 20 players per team, there's 320 players. Roman Turek had to be number one on the list for the guy that needed a good playoff more than anybody else, and he pulled it off. It's unbelievable. For San Jose, Scott Hannon, the young defenseman, had a great playoff. There's a lot of future there. And it was really too bad for Gary Suter, injured in the first minute of the whole series, and that really hurt San Jose.
Yeah, clearly, if you don't like this, you do not have a pulse. They better check you again. Oh. Right now, let's update you on the Penguins and the Capitals. This one also, three of our four games today, one goal games that came down to the final seconds. Right now, the Penguins clinging to a lead.
Timeout called. Pittsburgh finding a way to keep the lead. This has been a tight one. The Caps have only scored on the power play. That's it. 35 seconds to go. 2-2 is the series. The pivotal game, obviously, is this one. Can the Caps tie it up?
Also, we should let you know that Buffalo completed this annihilation of the Philadelphia Flyers. 8-0 is the final. So Buffalo advances to the next round, but nobody has any idea who they're playing. John Saunders alongside John Davidson. We told you three of the four games were one-goal games. It came down to empty nets in the final seconds of the game. Of course, Buffalo annihilates Philadelphia 8-0. But the last one of the three, Pittsburgh and Washington, this thing got ugly down the end of the game. In the final seconds again, Washington trying to score. They couldn't get it, so they're down 3-2 in the series. And then all something breaks loose.
This was after the final buzzer. Halperin, number 11 there for Washington, wanted to get at Kasparaitis. That started the whole thing, but the officials did a good job, separated most of the players. Trevor Linden even got a shot in on Mario Lemieux.
Darius Kasparaitis, as usual, was tossing his weight around, and that caused part of it. But again, now the Pittsburgh Penguins, they're headed home. That's even more huge, this win on the road against Washington, because now they go home with a chance to wrap it up.
A rookie goaltender has been unbelievable. He's allowed one even strength goal, Hedberg, for the Pittsburgh Penguins. A rookie, one even strength goal against. It's awesome.
Later tonight on ESPN, of course, it's Dallas against Edmonton. Good night. We'll see you next week. This has been a presentation of ABC Sports in association with ESPN. ABC Sports is online at ESPN.com. Now, most of you can stay tuned for World News Tonight, Saturday, or your local news. Well, those of you on the West Coast should stay tuned for coverage of the World Speed Skating Championships. This is ABC Sports, continuing the tradition of excellence.